Any question?
No, Dinesh.
Okay, what we discussed last time. Okay. For resource allocation, we have to discuss, right? That is the plan last time we just, right? Others, so basics we just discussed, let we try to import some of them in our integrations part as well. Okay. We'll do one thing. Before understanding to resource allocation, we must know how Spark is working internally. So via Docker Spark, I'm just trying to execute. Based on that, you may be understand. Okay. Let me just repeat this part. Let me start with the local and we'll compare it on there. Okay. Now this is just started. Okay, so job also started. I didn't do anything, just I'm open. Okay. I just type PySpark and directly enter into the environment. This is the interactive shell mode. Let me go and see this functionality. Spark master is running in a local mode. Okay. This is for the resource allocations, everything you want to understand, so that I just explaining you before this one. Once you understand these things, then we will be discuss these things. Because here you'll get more clear details while we are going to execute one way. Okay. So there's a local mode and Spark is just trying to execute it. In local mode, localhost 9090. Okay, so we just started in local mode, so it will not accept anything from the Spark master. This is a standalone mode. So total 12 GB is completely free, nothing was allocated. Now let me go and stop this job and submit one of them via host master. -fn master. And I just pass my master name from here. If this job is accepted, then you maybe get this information here. Running application, because before this job is submitted in your local mode, interactive local environment, so it will not be submitted. Now I just submit this job via Spark cluster. Now you can see the job will be accepted. And total core, completely whatever the cores is available, it tried to provide here itself. You can see this one. So total 9 core completely just allocated, as well as memory in use 12 GB is available by default 3 GB because each one of them by default 1 GB will be allocated. That's a default memory. Local mode. PySpark just allocate. All cores as plus 1 GB RAM only. Right? And the memory allocated 1 GB. Next, I just submit via master standalone. In the standalone mode, I didn't provide anything, just a Spark as master only, I just share it. So here, this is not a local course, it's an executive course. All will be allocated and each and executor course all memory has to be allocated 1 GB for this standalone. This is to your clear, right, everyone? Total 9 cores available. Everything has to be allocated this way. Total 9 core, entire the cluster total cores will be allocated. Any question in this? I will tell you next. If suppose I am going to provide some hard-coded value, what is happening? No, right? Now, I just going to be assigning a value. This box standalone itself, but I am going to mention total executor course. Okay, I just assigning only 4 now. Let me go here and see. So already this jobs is submitted. Now I just submit new job is running job. These are also completed job. In running job, you can see total number of core, whatever I mentioned, that only is just allocated. Memory per executor is 1024 MB only just allocated. Okay, I didn't run any codes till now, only that how that resource will be allocated in a Spark job. That is only we just discussed. If you have any doubt, just clearly ask me. This is very, very important. While you are going to submit your jobs in Spark cluster, this is must require this kind of knowledge. So if you have any question, just interrupt and ask me. Okay, fine. Now this is we have idea. Course will be evaluated. Okay, so core total 4 only I just mentioned, so 4 core only will be just allocated and memory also 1 GB. Now next command, what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to change the value. Okay, so let me go with the census. Okay, total executor core I just mentioned, and I'm trying to change the value for the executor memory to 2 GB. Now let me go here. You can see this one. Total core is 4 only I just mentioned. As I mentioned, it will be taking these values and executed memory 2 GB will be allocated. Let me go inside and see how the job will be running. Total 3 core will be allocated. So total 4 core I just mentioned. So executor ID, which means 0 executor allocated 2 cores with 2 GB RAM. Other 2 executor just allocated 1 GB only. You're able to understand this point.
Yeah, Dinesh. Dinesh, I have one. Who is responsible to allocate the cores and memory?
You are the developer, right? You are the responsible. That's what I just showing you one by one. Because you must submit your jobs. You're only creating all the commands, right? So they have some generics available, even though some places you won't allocate yourself.
But for every job, we don't know how much data will be there. How can we handle that number of cores and executors?
Don't worry, that we will be discussed after this part. Okay, so this is just an overview how Spark cluster will be expand and working internally, something like we just discussed. After that, I will tell you how to allocate resource memory.
Dinesh, you have assigned only 4 cores, but the executors 0 have 2 cores. Why?
Where?
here zero executor ID have two cores.
You cannot specifically mention the particular workers. It is a okay. common, right? You're just trying to allocate. Actually, your total cluster is three node only.
Okay.
So three worker you are using, one as a master, and three worker, total four node cluster. Okay?
Okay.
So each of them total 4 GB of memory is available.
Okay.
And this job is reserved each of them with the 2 GB. So that's the reason memory per executor. You can notice this part.
Yes, I but understand, but the cores were four cores, but the executor ID, right? Zero have two cores.
Okay. Now let me change the values there. Okay. If suppose I'm going to change the value from 4 to 5, what will happen now?
Executor zero, 1, 2, 3, but zero have a
now you can see 5 core allocated, each of them 2 GB of memory.
Correct.
Let me go inside and oh sorry. Here you can see executor 0 have 2, executor 1 have 2.
Okay.
Okay. Something like it will be validated inside and allocate the values.
Okay.
Okay, you can see this is the priority, something like we can consider. Okay.
Okay.
So based on the cores, how much you allocated for the job, based on that, the core will be allocated and RAM also will be allocated. Till now, everyone is clear, right?
Yeah.
Now, let me change the value from 4, okay, to 3 nodes cluster. I'm going to use it. Memory is 12 GB is available. Suppose 12 GB. Number of executor 9 we can allocate. Executor wise we can allocate. Number of executor 9. That's it. Okay. Let me try to allocate 8 cores. Okay, executor memory 2 GB. Okay, first we can run this one 2 GB and then I will tell you for the value changes. Okay, now it's just assigned. Let me go and refresh the route and we'll see that. Total 8, right? 8 core assigned and 4 worker just started. Sorry, 3 worker just started with each of them 3 and one only one as a 2. This we are seeing. Oh, where is it? I missed something. Okay. Executor cores. This is what I just meant. Okay. Okay, master, total executor 8, executor memory each of them 2 GB and executor core as 1. Now let me go here and see this one. Total 6 are legal reflective access by this platform to constructions. That's okay. No, it is total 9 code, 6 is used. Okay, got it. So here you can see this one, total 8 core I just allocated at this point, right? Total 8 core is assigned, but my cluster have maximum only for 12 GB RAM only. So it is trying to assign the value each executor 2 GB something. So maximum it can expand up to 6 node only, because each of them 2 GB, then it will be allocate 6 total 0 to 5. worker node has to be created in the backend based on the course of each one of them as well as memory. After that, the value will not be available. Total 8 courses allocated for this particular job, but only 6 has been granted, 2 will be left because there is no spaces available. Here also executed memory also completely full. You know, main Spark cluster, you can notice this one, 12 GB total, 12 GB completely locked. Now I just change this value. Again, I just provide this executed memory into 1. Okay, let me go here and start my job again. Okay, so total 8 core completely is used and 8 GB is just assigned. So this is a job application number 9. Application number 9, you can notice this one. This is assigned up to 8 executor. Because in the command you just mentioned, executor core has only 1, which means each executor can take only 1 core. And each executor can assign up to only 1 GB RAM. I also total executor will be allowed for this job is 8. So based on this 8 executor, based on this executor core, total executor core, 8 executor will be created and with respect to the RAM memory of 1 GB. You can see this one, 0 to 7 is available, each one of them. 1 core is available, each of them have 1 GB RAM will be allocated. Okay, before the job is just, where it is, this job is a 008 job. Job number 008, 6 core, each one of them 1 core allocated and 2 GB RAM. So due to the size of the cluster, it's not able to take another one job, so that it just left it to course additional whatever the RAM is not available, whatever the core is not available, it will not be taken. But here it's completely available, 8 core will be reserved, as well as each of them 1 GB can possible to allocate that manner. So 8 node has to be created and continue your process here, which means each worker, you can see this number. Okay, so here you can see this one, 172.0.0.0.3. This is a job number, okay, application number. 172.0.0.3. So this is the worker ID 1, I think. So worker ID 1, 3 will be allocated. Worker ID 2 core node will be allocated. And worker ID 3 allocated. 3 course. Okay, everything is the same worker only. You're supposed to go inside and see this one. Okay, this is the worker ID 1003. So you can see this one, this executor 3 is currently running, which means 3 core will be created and currently running now. Again, I am just going to check for worker ID 2. Only 2 core will be allocated, right? Let me copy this one. I'm showing you. This is a worker 2. So second worker, it will be allocated 2 core only. So 2 executors running per core with 1 GB of RAM space size. You're able to understand this point? This is very, very important. Any question or confusion?
No, sir.
No, Dinesh.
Everyone is clear, right? If
yeah.
I'm going to run my job based on some values, how this worker is going to be helped in the backend? Something like we are going to see that. And finally, I will tell you how the resource allocation we have to provide for your job, something like that. Okay, let me go with one by one. I just assigned 1 to 6 for time being. Okay. Okay, something I just tried. I didn't do anything. Just I allocate the job. Let me go to the job and see this one. Job number 10 is running, all others completed. Total 6 core I just allocated, with each one of them is 1 GB memory. Okay, this is the entire job's information. Okay, as well as I'm going to see that UI part. This is a Spark job UI. I just read the data from the CSP and showing the value. That's it. I didn't do anything more than that. Now, show string what is happening. It is just reading the data from the stages, completed stages. No specific changes has happened. Let me go here and see the total information. So here the master information, 6 executor I allocated, 0 to 5. That's the same you can see here. And additionally, 1 driver. Okay, so driver as well as 6 executor. So one should be a driver, another 6 is going to be performed based on your operations. And the task information, you can notice this one. Total till now, I just allocated 4 tasks, total task, and completed 4. So suppose any task has to be failed, that information will come. Any active task is running currently, that information will come here. For your understanding, I just created run the code. Okay, the TF task counts something, I'm going to use it. It just completed. So df1 equal to df dot duplicates df1 dot show. Okay. Now you can see one task has to be started. Okay. Based on this, 9 tasks has to be generated because some shuffling is happening. Once the shuffle is over, 165 total tasks, 165 tasks will be running. Based on this 165 task, everything will be completed because just I'm seeing only for the duplications removal. So total task is to be completed. Each executor you can notice. This executor will take 20 tasks and completed 20. As well as here 32 taking this task and completed. As well as every executor, they have allocated some task values. This number of tasks has to be complete there itself. If suppose any speculative executions, anything that you try to add it, and that situation, that particular executor goes down, other will take the responsibility and complete the task. And which executor goes down, that will consider as a failed task information assessment. Something like the calculations and values, everything we can see here. Let me run the code again. You can see this one. It is currently increasing the value. Total 400 tasks has to be created based on the shuffle partition value. 5 active tasks is running. This 5 active tasks will be split and store allocate to executor ID 0, 2, 3, 4. So 1 and 5 has 3 right now for time being. something like this operation is happening the back end. Doesn't have any question?
Sir, it decides automatically which executor to assign.
Yeah, it will be taken care by your drivers. Okay, driver in a master program, sorry, in a standalone, driver is a separate will act like a new node in your Hadoop, right? So it just allocate the task and it will be completely sitting idle. But in your Hadoop cluster yarn deployment, your resource manager will be taking care about this driver operation. All other executors are going to be support based on your yarn. Okay. What are the command and resource manager will be creating the job that will be monitored by the your yarn operations with multiple node clusters. Let me go with some examples in visual. Okay, so if suppose you are going to submit your job, okay, this is a standalone. First, we will be discussing. I'm allocating three workers, so worker one, worker two, worker three, and this is the master. So this master, whatever the commands you will be going to provide the task, right? It is going to be create the applications number. Application ID will be created. Based on that, it will be allocate all your resources with your workers. So worker, what it is trying to do, it is creating the executor insight with respect to the course values as well as memory based. If suppose you will be allocate more core, it will be creating more executors here. Based on the memory and core, it will be reserved the places. Same like here also. So it will be process your data and giving you the output. This is normal standalone. If the same you are trying to submit in your Hadoop environment, this master will be taking care based on your yarn node. And this application ID will be created based on your resource manager. All other worker will be available on top of your data node itself. So it will be taking care your operations there based on node managers. You remember, right? This node manager will be taking care of the responsibility and complete your task here. Okay. Are you able to understand? Clear?
Yeah.
Any questions? This is very, very important.
No, Dinesh.
Okay, fine. Because most of the interview, they will ask your the questions on top of this one. How much you are good with Spark development and how to allocate the memory and all something, they will be raised sufficient. So you want to answer this on this one.
Dinesh, I have one doubt here.
Get
Hello?
Get
yeah, just you in that query, you are just dropping only duplicates, right? For that, it is creating a number of tasks, right? 165 tasks like that, it is creating, right?
Yeah, correct.
Yeah, for actually, the based on number of tasks will be created based on number of partition, right? That also will be right, right?
No, that's I'm saying, right? If any shuffle has happened, this value by default will be created by 200. Let me run the code again. Let me, okay, for you to understand. Now this task has to be complete, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so nothing was there. Let me... So how much? 481 task has to be complete.
Okay.
Now I'm going to change the shuffle partition value into 6. Okay, something or 12. Well, let me change it. A 20 maximum. Now let me go into run the code again. 481 task only just allocated. plus how much it is? 20, right? How much it will come?
Yeah, 502, yeah.
Exactly, right? Again, I'm running my code. You can see this one. up to 20 related shuffle partition is just allocated for this task. Because based on your executors, it just reserved. 12, 18, you may provide, 24 you can provide, that will exactly you'll get this proper information.
That 481, the 481 number will depends on which one? That
which one?
The task first it is 481, right? Before that.
That is the default shuffle partition 200. That's what I say. Okay. Shuffle partition default is 200. Last session, that is what I explained. So if you are not mentioning anything, by default value, it's just reserved. Let me go and run the code again. So stop this one and run it again. Okay. I didn't do anything. New job, as well as I'm going to allocate this values. There's a fresh job, so no information is available. Total task is zero. Let me go into run this code. It is time to read the data from this part. So here you can notice complete task is only one right run. Okay. So let me go and do some group by dot count dot show. Okay. This group by operation only take two tasks.
Okay.
So let me go on the df dot show. How much it is? Based on the age, I may be sorting it. DS dot order by age. One task. Four tasks has to be complete. No, show something like that. Okay, this one will take only one. Surprise. Okay. I will do one thing. Remove the drop duplicates. I just remove the duplicates and then I am trying to sort by this age value and then showing to you. Or I just remove this order. Oh my god. Sorry, guys. So 6 core, 1 GB RAM and 1 executable core I just selected. And I reserve some values here. Again, it will be back to 1. The new test, right? Okay, something running in the back end, I think so. One, two, three, four. Okay. Okay, 4041. Already job is running. Something wrong. Two tasks currently running, that's what it is, this kind of values. So 4041, right? Let me kill this job. Let me try to kill this also. Okay. The protocol will be disconnected. Let me go into passing the value again. Okay, now Spark job has to be started. 14th job. Go to 6 core allocator. So 6 core informations as well as the job is executed. Okay, zero task. So data frame one, only one task completed, df dot drop duplicates dot show. You can see by default job will be increased right now. This task is maximum try to execute up to 158 task sizes. Okay, those are by default shuffle values. Let me go into run this code based on this one. If suppose you are trying to execute this command, restrict this number of shuffle partition values. Almost 158 partition has to be created to complete this only one task. This only one, right? You can see this one. This task will be, everything will be combined from here. 4, 20, 100, 10, 11, 11. These are all the combinations. Everything will be combined together, then we will be running it. So you'll get this detailed information. So stage will be skipped and then the task has to be completed. Each executed task or each task, how it is running in the backend, based on this task ID numbers. Everything is just represented here. Same like multiple shows will be created, right? The multiple stages. If supposed to run this, open this one, you can see this information as well. This is running for up to 100 tasks. So 100 task number will be available and you can see this executor ID. So executor ID 0 will be allocated up to this number. This are all will be allocated. Let me go with sorting index. So task ID 0, task ID here. Task ID 27 just started for the stages. This stage number task 27 executor 4 will be taking care. Task number 28 will be taken care by executor 5. Task number 29 executor 1. As well as 33, 31, 0. Something like total you have 6 executor running for this job. Everything in the shuffle just allocated and continue process here. Okay, this is the by default value. If you want to change this, then you can use this command. So let me go into change to up to 12. Let me run the same code, 159 plus 12, how much? 160, 171 plus 1 is for the driver. Same transformation, drop duplicate without shuffle partition. I just tried to execute at the time. Almost 158 tasks will be created. After the shuffle partition, I just restrict to 20 or 12 something. It is restricted based on this values. Okay, you are able to understand the performance tuning here.
Yes, Dinesh.
If suppose I'm changing this value to only one, let's see the interesting thing. 172 only, right? Let me go and run the code. Only one task will be replaced. Okay. The shuffling the partition value, you just restrict it based on your shuffle partitions.
Two tasks.
Come again.
It increased by 2, right?
There is a task you just execute, right? Two tasks will be allocated for this task. Shuffle for one. Once the shuffle is over, then another one will be taking care for your driver operations. Right?
Okay, so one is already for driver.
Yeah. So whatever you mention, n plus one something will come. If you want to know this detail, you just go to the log information. There also you can. log information is not available for this task. Okay, so some container problem is happening in the backend so that you cannot be able to see the logs. Okay, but you are able to see the logs here as well. Standard output, standard error, both you can see this log information. Okay, here you can see this one. There's a log information. How this co-executor is trying to execute in the backend. Executor command, when I'm going to submit, it is taking backend look like this one. Okay, so based on this driver URL, it just submit their responses. And what are the executor? It just execute the value and the connections. This is a connect. This worker has to be connected with your master. That information will be provided. And hope you are able to see right now. So based on the default properties values and the worker information, it try to connect with your respective worker on top of your masters, and it's start their operation with executor ID 0 with that internal port number. So 172.0.0.5, so internal port number, just take it out and starting their functionality. These are the shuffle, how many shuffles are happening, that information. So once the shuffle is over, this kind of bytes will be sent back to your driver. Finally, driver will be collect this information. Each shuffle is happening, right? Each task. The shuffle, whenever is happening, it is trying to send back that shuffle output to the driver. Driver will be collect all the combination at the end and producing you at the final output. Okay, this is happening inside. You're able to understand?
Yes, Dinesh.
Okay, this is the way it's internally execute all your functionality. Based on this performance tuning, last time we just discussed, right? What are the combination you just provide? Based on this functionality, will be changes internally and execute. Okay. Any question, guys? This is a very, very important thing. They may be asked about data locality and level of parallelisms, as well as the memory allocations, everything they may be asked. Hope you are clear or any question. If suppose you are clear, then we will discuss the next point, how to mention the submission values. Any question till now? For your understanding is very, very important here. Most of the interview, they will ask this kind of questions only. What's happening inside? That's what I just run almost 15 times. I just run the core and will show you what is happening inside. These are the completed tasks. This is just to be killed at this stage. So you can see this value, killed status, and who is the user, and how many times, and how long this will be running the backend. And each executor wise, we just going to validate when this job will be submitted. Everything you can notice here. These are also kind of history values. Are you clear?
Yeah, then.
Okay, I will raise some questions to try to answer. Then only I can confirm you have some clear idea. Okay, so let me change this value to 4. This is also 4 executable code. So what will happen in the backend?
3 will be created, right? You had 12.
We'll get 4 executors, right?
How many executors? How many worker? Sorry, how many worker will be created in the backend?
You had 12 GB RAM, right? So 3.
4 three executors. Yeah. There will be 4 executors.
Others?
Oh, 1 GB, right?
Each executor memory 1 GB.
Yeah.
So there will be 4 executors. Each executor will be allocated 1 GB memory.
Yes. You have like 16 core, right? How many cores system you have? 9 cores. Okay. So it will be 2.
12 GB total core memory is available. Okay. Here it also you can notice. Okay, so 12 GB and 9 core.
So 2 workers will be there, right?
Total worker is 3. Alive workers is 3 right now. So suppose I am going to submit this job, how many workers will be running the backend with respect to your executors? How many executors will be created? And how much RAM is just allocated?
2.
Okay.
So 2 executors with 4 core each, right? And 2 GB RAM will be allocated. 1 GB each.
Okay. Let me run and see the output. If your answer is correct, then fine. Otherwise, I will not move to the next. You can see what is happening.
0 cores.
0.
Why?
Oh, 3 cores. Okay, because it is exceeding the limit.
It cannot be assigned because driver also is impacted, right?
Okay, I thought it will apply the same concept like RAM. So if RAM is less, it will allocate.
Okay. Next, I will go to assign 2. Now, how much?
9 cores, right? So for it will allocate 4 executors. 4 executors will be there. And 4 GB RAM. And 1 core will be remaining.
Okay. Sixteen. How much it just allocated?
2 executors.
Why? You mentioned 4, right?
Yeah.
How? What is happening?
It depends upon the number of memory and allocation.
Okay. You have not clearly noticed this values. What is the value I just mentioned here?
Actually, total cores are 4 and 4. Executors are 2.
Oh, okay.
Which means?
4 cores and 2 executors.
Same like here, right? Total 4 cores is just allocated for this job. Per executor, you just allocated 2. So per executor, 2 cores will be allocated. So how much maximum it can generate?
4.
Okay.
Two executor only can generate it. Okay. Let me go and change the value to 6. Okay, same job, just change the value to 6. This one. Now you can see total 6 is available. So 3 executors has to be generated in the back. Okay. Because total 6 is available, total core for this job 6, I can allocate each of them 2. So maximum how much I can provide? 3 executor I can create with each of them 2 total something. Right?
Yes, yes.
What if I'm going to change the value to 5? What will happen?
Only 2 executor.
Total 1.
Three executors?
2 executors, Dinesh.
2 to 1. 3 executors with 2, 2, and 1 core.
Only 2. Total 5 allocated, right? 4 has to be granted, 1 has to be left. Because you mentioned per executor is 2. Executor core, right? Each executor, at least 2 cores should be available. Right? So it is less than that, so that it will not be allowed to create a third executor. What the same case, if suppose I am not mentioning this values, executor core, I will not be mentioning it. Then how much will create in the backend?
Now it's 3. 3 it will create.
So total 19, right? Job number. Oh my God, sorry. Okay, total 5 core is just allocated. Executor limit based each of the 1 GB RAM. So it just created the indicators. Okay. So depends on the value, whatever you mentioned, it will be changing. This is just top standard.
One left is there, right? If you are giving that 3-4 executor as 2. Executor core 2, then it is giving as 1 is left. What is that one?
Where? Previous one.
Yeah, executor core 2. For these 5 core executors, we gave
total executor you mentioned as a 5.
5. Right? And
executor core, each executor should have 2 core.
2, 4, and 1 is left. Okay.
Yeah, because it cannot be created with only one executor core. Because this is a minimum condition you mentioned. At least I need 2 core. If less than that, it will not be allowed to create it. That's the reason it just skipped to 1. Okay?
Okay.
Please, I have one doubt here.
Yeah, please.
If you don't mention executor core 2, then also it is creating a 3 executor, right? 2, 2, 1. Instead of why can't it create 1, 1 for 5 executor?
That's what I'm showing you. This is 19, right? So 5 cores you allocated. So based on that, it will be created 3. Previous job you mentioned at least 2 core for executor, so that it will not be allowed to create a third executor here.
No. Finally, if you don't give any condition, it is creating 3 executor, 2 core, 2 core, and 1 core, right? Why don't it go for 1, 1 core, 5 executor, I'm asking.
Then you can mention this values, executor core as a 1, that's it.
Okay.
So now you can see this values.
Now 1, 1 core will be allocated for 5 core, total 5 cores, allocate 1.
By default, if we don't give the value.
Yeah, so let me go on, show you this one.
So basically, if we don't allocate executive cores, it will utilize all the cores. I mean, it will divide and whatever the remaining residue, it will assign a single core for that.
Exactly. Now you are able to understand, right? What is happening?
Yeah,
Dinesh. We are here.
Okay, this is very, very important. Okay, only 1 minute, guys.